Hello everyone. In this session, I'll be discussing signal flow graph reduction methods. Actually, there are two methods of doing signal flow graph reduction. The first method is you can reduce the signal flow graph by using different rules of signal flow graph algebra. That is the first method. The second method is you can go for Mason's gain formula. So we can say that by using the rules of signal flow graph, it is possible to reduce the signal flow graph. Or else you can go for Mason's gain formula. There are two methods are available. Actually, if you depending on different signal flow graph algebra methods, like we have familiar different types of rules, the main problem is the procedure become too complex. It is too lengthier also. So that by depending on that particular signal flow graph algebra, it is very difficult to find out the signal flow graph reduction. At this point, we can depend the popular formula. It is namely Mason's gain formula. It is designed by Mason, S.J. Mason. That is why it is known as Mason's gain formula. So we can calculate the transfer function of a signal flow graph easily with the help of Mason's gain formula. In spite of depending on the different rules of signal flow graph, the method is too simple. That is why we are mainly using the Mason gain formula for calculating the transfer function from the given signal flow graph. That means you can identify the relation between output and input. We can easily calculate the transfer function by applying that particular formula. Today I'll be showing you how to calculate the transfer function with the help of Mason's gain formula. Let us have a brief discussion. So what do you mean by Mason's gain formula and what is the importance of this formula? Actually, signal flow graph of a system can be reduced by using this popular formula, that is namely Mason's gain formula. And the Mason's gain formula is normally used to determine the transfer function of the signal flow graph of the given system. So let's consider R of S is the input of the system and C of S is the output of the system. Now, the general formula for transfer function is TF, or you can call T of S, that is given by C of S by R of S. All are in S domain. Okay. So Mason gain formula is given by the transfer function T is equal to, you can calculate the transfer function T, that is equal to 1 by delta into sigma k pk into delta k. So this is the formula, that is namely Mason's gain formula, one of the popular formula in the signal flow graph. This is really useful to calculate the transfer function of a complicated signal flow graph, where T is the transfer function. T is equal to T of S, that is the transfer function of the system. Okay. Similarly, PK, one term is available here. PK, what is PK? PK is nothing but forward path gain of kth forward path. What do we mean by K? K is nothing but the number of forward paths in the signal flow graph. You should have a good observation. From the given signal flow graph, you need to determine how many forward path will be there. Then based on the particular forward path, you have to calculate forward path gain. Okay, that means PK is nothing but forward path gain of kth forward path, and K is the number of forward path in the given signal flow graph. Now what is delta here? You can observe delta. You can observe delta is available here. What do you mean by delta? So delta is equal to 1 minus sum of individual loop gains plus sum of gain products of all possible combinations of two non-touching loops minus sum of gain products of all possible combination of three non-touching loops plus sum of gain products of all possible combinations of four non-touching loops minus sum of gain product of all possible combinations of five non-touching loops and so on. This process will be repeated, okay, depending on the number of non-touching loops, number of combinations of non-touching loops. You can continue the combination. Here, 1 minus sum of individual loop gain. You know what is individual loop? So you have to identify how many individual loops are available. So you have to calculate the sum of individual loop gain first. And the sum of gain products of all possible combinations of non-touching loops. You have to identify the possibility. What are the available non-touching loops are in this particular signal flow graph? How many possible combinations of two non-touching loops are available here? Similarly, you have to identify how many combinations of three non-touching loops are available. If it is available, you have to take, else you can ignore. No issues. So, we have come to know what do we mean by K. K is nothing but forward path. And we identified what is PK. PK is nothing but forward path gain of kth forward path. And we computed how to calculate delta. Delta is the particular thing in the signal flow graph. It can be calculated by using 1 minus sum of individual loop gain plus sum of gain product of all possible combinations of two non-touching loop minus sum of gain product of all possible combinations of three non-touching loop plus etc. etc. Okay. Now let me ask one thing. How do you calculate delta k? There is one more term, that is delta k. How to calculate delta k? Delta k is nothing but the delta for that part of the graph which is not touching kth forward path. You have to identify the nature of forward path and you need to find out the delta for that part of the graph which is not touching kth forward path. That is very important. Okay. So this is actually the way how to calculate delta k. Whenever you are solving the problem, I will be explaining more on delta k. How to determine delta k. Time being, you need to understand the particular formula that is known as Mason's gain formula. So this is the popular formula that is known as Mason's gain formula that is given by 1 by delta into sigma k pk into delta k. Suppose there are two forward paths are available. In a signal flow graph, there are two forward paths. Let me say there are two forward paths. How we can modify the equation? That means transfer function can be calculated as 1 by delta into p1 into delta 1 plus p2 delta 2. If it is 3, correspondingly, you can modify the particular equations. So, this is the way how to calculate the transfer function by using Mason's gain formula. Hope you understood the session. Thank you for watching this video. Please share and don't forget to subscribe.